Hello everyone, today we are going to learn one more important topic in class 9, that is biosphere. See, bio is nothing but it is life. Life is possible only on the earth surface, because earth planet is the only one of the suitable planet for all living things. All living organisms are living on the earth planet, because here air is available, water is available, natural resources available, forests are there. So that is why all living things are living on the earth planet. So which have life on the earth, which have life, that all comes under the biosphere. Bio is nothing but is the life. So in this chapter, we are going to learn, see, some of the living things are living in the water, some are living in the forest area, and some living on the earth. See, small creatures, from the small creature, from small bacteria to very big animals and like elephants and human beings, all these are living on the earth planet. Everything comes under the bio, which have life. Small bacteria, virus to very big living things which are there, but all comes under the biosphere. Because these living things come, for example, you take animals. So animals are living in the forest area, because forests are their shelters. In the forest, what they want, all the animals, they can feed and they get the food, so that all the animals are living in the forest. So the biosphere chapter, the main important points is natural vegetation also comes under the biosphere. See, natural vegetation is nothing but forest. So plants, trees, these also biosphere. Plants also have life. So plants takes the like water and minerals from the earth, and plants will grow and it give the food to other animals. Okay, plants also comes under the living things. So these natural vegetation, they are forest or again different types. In the natural vegetation also comes under the biosphere, that keep in mind. Natural vegetation also comes under the biosphere. So these natural vegetations on the earth, they divided into many types of natural vegetations are there. So one is tropical evergreen forest, tropical deciduous forest, temperate evergreen forest, temperate deciduous forest, Mediterranean vegetation, coniferous forest. So these are all natural vegetations. So in this area, in the natural vegetation, different types of living things are living in this area. For example, you take the tropical evergreen forest. In the tropical evergreen forest area, one variety types of animals and birds, creatures are living in this area. And tropical deciduous forest are the same, when different types of animals, birds, creatures are living in this area. Same like all types of forest. So these natural vegetation also comes under the biosphere. And next one, grasslands. So the land which is covered completely grass, so that we can call grasslands. So grassland again divided into, we classified into four parts, same like tropical grasslands, temperate grasslands, chronic bushes, tundra vegetation. So these are the grasslands. But natural vegetation is completely depending on the sunshine and rainfall. Natural vegetation depends on the sunshine and sunlight, rainfall. maybe on the Earth planet, some regions get heavy rainfall and some regions will get the scanty rainfall. So based on the sunlight and the rainfall temperature, so these natural vegetations also divided total 5 types. Okay. So first one I would like to explain about tropical evergreen forest. See, already there clearly you know that evergreen means this forest, that trees looks greenery always throughout the year. So evergreen forest area. Trees can save their leaves, but we can't find. We save the leaves and immediately new leaves will come. Because it is a dense forest, we can't see that when the trees save their leaves. So that is why it looks throughout the year greenery. So we can say that it is a tropical evergreen forest area. So in the tropical evergreen forest areas, heavy rainfall and heavy temperature. So that here trees will grow very high. And here the trees are very thick forest area in the tropical evergreen forest area. Maybe in the tropical evergreen forest also we can call that another name is that tropical rainforest also you can say very easy. Tropical rainforest. Here heavy rainfalls. In this region, heavy rains. So that here looks always the trees looks greenery, heavy rainfall, heavy temperature. So it is very near to the equator. So that is why here thick forest. And we can call other name is tropical rainforest. This is evergreen forest. And very important wood you will get like hardwood. Hardwood you will get in this forest area. So valuable wood we will get in the forest area. Next, after the tropical evergreen, next to tropical deciduous. Tropical deciduous forest. What is the tropical deciduous forest? Simple. So this deciduous forest, the other name is we can call that monsoon forest. These forests depending on the monsoon. In the monsoon season period, the trees looks greenery. New leaves will come. Trees save their leaves in the summer season. And next rainy season, the new leaves will come. So these we can call a tropical deciduous forest. Another name is monsoon forest. Here, summer season, these trees save their leaves. And next rainy season, again, it looks greenery. But here, mainly, in this important trees is neem trees, teak, saal, hardwood. These are the main important wood trees are growing in this tropical deciduous forest. Hardwood, teak, neem trees, saal. So these famous important trees growing in this tropical deciduous forest. And here in this area, some important birds and animals are living in this region that we can call that tigers, elephants, lions, okay, langurs, monkeys. These are the common animals are living in this tropical deciduous forest area. Okay, same line, next one, temperate evergreen forest area. Temperate evergreen forest. See, these temperate evergreen forest, it is mainly located in the central region latitude like mainly these type of temperate evergreen forest are located in the mid-latitudinal coastal regions, we can see that. Mid-latitudinal and coastal areas we can find this type of temperate evergreen forest area. For example, in the southeast USA, south China, southeast Brazil, and completely we can see these type of temperate evergreen forest. Okay, so here mainly softwood we will get. Softwood trees we will get like oak trees, pine trees, eucalyptus trees are growing in this temperate evergreen forest area. And temperate deciduous forest. So temperate deciduous forest are mainly higher latitude area it will grows. For example, USA, China, New Zealand, Chile, as well as coastal regions of Western Europe. Okay. So temperate deciduous forest mainly it will grow higher latitudes. There are more temperate deciduous forest in the world. For example, China, USA, New Zealand, Chile. Okay, in these places, number of temperate deciduous forest growing in this area. So the main important trees here are also oak trees, ash trees, and birch. These are the main important oak, ash, beech. Next one, birch. These are the important trees are growing in the temperate deciduous forest. Mainly, it will grow in the higher latitudes. Important animals which are living in this region: deer and foxes, wolves. These are the commonly living in this found in this area. Birds also, mainly birds important monarchs and finnans. These are the important birds are living in